ladies and gentlemen. My name is Liz Zakaria, and today I will be speaking to you about the economic aspects associated with power quality disturbances. So in today's society, as the need for electricity increases, reliability and quality of supply are two essential features to meet customer demands. Poor power quality, however, remains a prevalent issue affecting both end users and the utility. It's important that we analyse the economic effects of poor power quality so that utilities and customers can determine the amount of costs which they need to spend on mitigation devices to protect their equipment from poor power quality. So what is power quality? Power quality is any voltage, current, or frequency deviation which can result in the malfunction of end user equipment. There are two categories of power quality problems. So you have your short-term events, and these typically last for a couple of seconds and they occur over a period of time. And they include voltage sags, voltage swells, and transients. And then you have your steady state events, which are continuously ongoing power quality problems, and they're like harmonics and voltage flicker. So my motivation for researching this topic is the fact that previous research has been conducted to determine the reliability and quality of supply, as well as there's methods to calculate like power loss and the equipment damage to equipment due to harmonics and stuff like that. And also like simulations have been conducted to characterize voltage sags and determine like equipment sensitivity to voltage sags. However, the economic aspects associated with these problems has not been looked at in a great deal. So my project aims to investigate the economic consequences of power quality. For my project, I'll focus on harmonics and voltage sags, and then I aim to develop a method that allows the cost quantification of costs associated with these disturbances, and then conduct a case study on a small industrial plant just to see how much money they're losing due to the poor power quality. So my methodology, it consists of two parts. The first part is to determine the equipment power loss under harmonic conditions, and then to find out like the resulting lifetime of equipment when they're subject to harmonics. And then also find out the probability of equipment tripping when subject to voltage sags. After that, after finding that out, I can determine the cost associated with power loss, equipment failure, and voltage sag stopping a process. So for my case study, I developed a small industrial plant and utility using PSCAD software. My industrial plant consists of typical loads that you can find in any real life plant, such as your compact fluorescent lights, personal computers, variable speed drives, and DC motors, just to name a few. And because my project considers the financial losses to both the customers and the utility, for the customer, I consider the money they lose when power loss is increased in their cable and when the cable lifetime is reduced due to the harmonics. And also I consider how much money they lose when a voltage sag stops a process. And for the utility, similarly, I consider how much money the utility is losing when their distribution transformer is affected by harmonics. So for my case study, I considered harmonics up to the 19th order. This was because from my simulation results, harmonics above the 19th order had like current magnitudes below 0.001 amps, and hence I considered them insignificant in calculations. And then I also considered voltage sags lasting for 100 to 400 milliseconds with 50 to 80% nominal voltage range. So for my cable power loss, it was assumed that my plant had a total of 50 kilometers worth of cabling installed, and it had a cross-sectional area of 50 millimeters squared. Then I determine the power loss under sinusoidal conditions when there's no harmonics, and then I inject harmonics into the system through my simulations and find out how much power, like how much power they lose when there's harmonics. So customers typically pay like a certain amount of money per kilowatt hour to produce energy. So when power is lost, the money that they invested to produce that power is also lost. So to determine how much money they lose due to power loss, I multiply the power loss by the cents per kilowatt to produce that power with a correction factor. The correction factor is used just to, so you consider the amount of money they lose during the plant's operational hours only. So from my results, it was found that the plant loses 245 kilowatts in the cables due to harmony under sinusoidal conditions, and this cost results in $6,442 being lost per annum. As you can see from the table, with increased levels of harmonic distortions, the increase in power loss in the cable is increased significantly, which also in turn increases the amount of money which the plant is losing annually. So for power cables, they have a maximum operating temperature of 90 degrees Celsius and expected life of around 40 years. But when cables are carrying harmonic currents, the harmonics reduce the cable's life because the operating temperature increases, resulting in an increase in deterioration rate of the cable's insulation. So to find out the actual lifetime of a cable when it's exposed to harmonics, I determined the operating temperature of the cable under different levels of harmonic conditions, and then I applied it to the Arrhenius equation that finds out its actual life. And then I can find out the cost using this equation when the life of the cable is reduced. So for 50 kilometers worth of cable, it costs $19 million just to install it, and over 40 years, it costs $494,000 for the plant. As it began with higher levels of harmonic distortions, you can see that the operating temperature has increased significantly from 90 degrees to 107 degrees, and this results in the life being decreased from 40 years to 16 years, and it costs the plant quite a lot of money annually due to the harmonics. So for the utility distribution transformer, I analyzed the power loss under 20% to 89% loading. And the cost power loss consists of two parts, the no load losses and the load losses. So it was found that they lose 27 kilowatts, costing them $709. And when you have a lot of harmonic distortions, they lose $728 annually. $700 might not seem like a lot, but it should be kept in mind that the plant that I modeled was quite small, so $700 seems quite like a significant amount of money. For the transformer loss of life, it varies depending on the harmonic distortion it's exposed to, and you can determine it using these formulas. So I found out that the cost is increased annually when there's higher amounts of harmonics. So for a purchase price of $200,000, the annual earning of a transformer is $5,000 per year over 40 years. And that table shows that when the life is reduced, the annual earning cost of the transformer is increased. For voltage sags, when you have a voltage sag, the process is stopped, and when the process is stopped, that this costs money to the plant because they're not producing like some output that they require. So you can find out the number of process trips of a plant using this formula. This is just displays like the equipment configuration of my plant. All my equipment have been connected in series, while like each equipment group are connected in parallel with each other. And then to find out the actual number of process trips that occur during plant operational hours, I used a correction factor of 0.2384. And then I can find out the cost of a sag by using this data from the table, which was found from previous researchers. So it cost my plant $17,000 annually when a voltage sag occurred. And you can see like when you have a long duration of voltage sag with a least amount of nominal voltage remaining, the cost incurred is the most, like the cost losses to the plant incurred is the most amount of money, so this highlights the problem with the power quality issue. Okay, so in conclusion, a small-scale industrial plant was successfully developed and simulated. By developing this plant, it enabled me to obtain real harmonic data which I could use in my calculations and also simulate the voltage sags at the point of common coupling and see like how far it propagates through the equipment in the plant and see which equipment is affected or not affected by the sag. I also developed an economics method to compute the financial losses due to the poor power quality to both the plant and the utility. It's found that quite a lot of money is being lost due to these power quality disturbances, highlighting the fact the importance of this topic.